Hello, welcome to the Stephen Tries Podcast, Series 3, Episode 15!
Whoa!
Oh, I'm a clicker now, I forgot, yeah. Another two-finger clap, did you ever do that? You gave your own two fingers and she got the clap.
Yeah.
This week I'm joined by Ryan Locke.
Ryan!
Ah. Sorry, I thought
nice shot of his crotch there.
Yes, you can. You stand up, we can't see you.
Yeah,
yeah. To be fair, for some people, they can't see him ever.
Yeah.
True.
His father, after what he did. completely unrelated. Have you watched the Jimmy Savile documentary? Also joined by Tom Looney.
Yeah, thank you.
Looney.
Cheers, Looney. As always. Looney.
And Max Smith.
Hello there!
Smithy! I think of James Corden when I say that.
Smithy, yeah.
Oh, God, that's horrible. Why, how? Oh, we're overweight, well done, Tom.
Wow, why would you go there, man? Why would you go there?
What else do me and him have in common?
He's a highly talented comedian.
You came straight for JC.
You've never said that. You've said the opposite. Yeah,
he's 5'7"?
Loved by the public.
Sure,
People's champion.
Ryan, you've got a new job.
Yeah.
Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
A round of applause, please, for Ryan's job.
Yeah.
His dream job.
Well done, man.
Yeah. You know his dream job. Yeah. He wants a line in the show. That's still... Make that dream happen, guys.
Yeah, that's still in there.
Your dad could do that. Oh, his show got cancelled.
Glad you got out of 2 giants. I know you weren't happy there.
Yes. Well, it was only... This tour guide job is only one day a week anyway.
Yeah, but it was a stepping stone to something.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Well, a stepping stone.
Journey of 1,000 miles takes a single step.
It's a new path that you're guiding yourself.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Another round of applause, I think.
Yeah, wow.
Well,
I know how happy you've been. I know what you wanted.
I did want it.
You inspire me every day, man.
You can get too much too fast.
You've got it, baby. You've got it.
Right. So I got it on the Saturday.
Right, he's touring us again.
Wow.
That's good.
And I left on Monday.
Left?
No, I really... I've left.
That's insane.
But I'm starting again next
month. Are you kidding?
Yeah.
March.
Next March.
It's full tour is reference to fucking March.
Yeah.
It wasn't one day a week. It was one day a year. This one day a year job that you left TGI for. You left TGI Fridays for a one day a year job. Right. Wow, incredible.
It pays well.
Are you leading drug smugglers or something? Yeah.
That's the only way.
Are you Father Christmas?
No, I just worked.
I've done a whoopsie.
I set a shoe guard in December. You get your presents when I'm ready.
What happened?
Well, I've decided I'm going to do a pantomime this year.
Oh my God.
And they need someone who's all year round.
All year round to do a pantomime.
One day a week. The tour guides, they need someone who's
right. Okay.
All year round, one day a week.
What are you doing your panto?
Same companies before.
Oh, you've gone back to the old company.
Yeah.
You couldn't even just say to them, "I can't do Fridays."
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Right.
What's the pantomime you're doing?
Don't know yet. I've requested Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah.
So hopefully I'll be Lumiere or Gaston. Well, I'll be both. If I get that show, I'll be both.
Didn't you do an amateur production of Beauty and the Beast?
Gaston, eh?
In university?
Yes.
Who did you play in that?
Yes. I played a dame. Mother something.
Mother something.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mother Meredith, something like
that. I literally don't know. Why would I?
Something like
did we go to that?
I thought you played like a wardrobe or something.
No.
Oh.
Your acting was wooden.
Slam dunked in your face, man.
Yeah, we found that for ages, man.
I pulled my neck as I turned.
A real so joke excited. On the podcast.
Ooh.
God.
That's the sort of reaction you would have seen if you had some good actors in your show, but you didn't.
But yeah, very excited about that. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
I'll keep you all posted.
Oh, Ryan, yes. We decorated your room.
Yeah.
How's that going?
Yes, it's lovely. I'm starting to get a bit bored of the vagina.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
What I mean, like, you know.
So it starts.
First few days. For the first few days, I would look at the vagina, forget that it was there, and be like, oh. But now it's just like, ah.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you mean, ah?
And I'm worried that, you know, when I do see a vagina, I'll just go, ah.
Yeah, you're worried about that.
Yeah, yeah, just be disappointed.
Really?
Because that's that good.
It's very good for China.
Tom, you're going to Italy.
Yes, Stephen. Very excited.
No!
Italian!
No!
Good look at his face.
Shut up!
Are you all right?
No, not at all, man.
What's wrong?
No, man.
Why has this affected you?
Where's
so
my
much?
Invite?
That's a good point.
Where's our invite?
Oh, we got an invite.
Let's go.
Oh, what? Shut up. Really?
I'm always inviting you to stuff.
Yeah, not to Italy, though. I'd go there.
Going to Naples, and I'm going to Nipples back. Nice
yes.
Nipples.
Yeah,
don't need a guide. Don't need a guide for these. Wow. Yeah. Need a fucking razor. What would you rather do? See the sights or eat the food?
Oh, so I've been binging on Searching for Italy with Stanley Tucci this last week. Really good show.
Nice.
Great. Look, yeah, very nice guy as well.
Did he find Italy? I think a man with his resources, he should have.
He's not left the library yet.
He's in the process. He's visiting all the different regions and it's all very food-based.
Yeah.
So it's nice. It's really got me going. I made some pasta last night.
Oh!
Little Italian.
Little known fact there, that is Italian food.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. God, I'm learning a lot today.
You got mac and cheese?
Yeah.
Oh, mac and cheese, tucked in bed, looking at a big vagina. You're living the bachelor life, my man.
Are you going to heat it up?
Yeah, yeah.
It'll be hot enough in that room.
Am I right? Yeah.
Yeah. Max, what have you been up to?
Great question, Stephen.
Yeah.
I've actually been buying a lot of reduced items from the shop. This is good. This is good because...
Okay, it's a start. Go on.
Did you see the woman, Susanna Reid interviewed Boris Johnson about the 75-year-old woman who's... she gets her pension, which is £170 a week.
Wow.
And her gas prices have gone from £17 to £81.
17 to 81?
So she has to go out late at night to get the yellow sticker food and she gets on the bus of a morning with a free pass and just sits on that to not waste energy at home. And Boris Johnson's first thing he said to that was, I actually introduced that bus pass.
What are you fucking on?
That's another win for Boris.
Terrible.
Really fucking terrible.
Sad. I mean, it is, I shouldn't be laughing.
My energy's gone up from 80 quid.
To does it seem
not on
like
the podcast.
It?
Oh, yes.
190 of fucking quid.
A month.
My last one was 400.
What?
What are you doing here?
You fucking lied. I'm always ready for the podcast.
I guess you work out of here, don't you?
Yeah, work out.
Yeah, always working out.
Had to save these pennies. Fuck you, Boris,
That's outrageous.
What?
Ooh.
Plus, what I'm annoyed about is that's another person getting access to the yellow sticker food before I do.
I think you're wasting money the way you travel the country. Yellow sticker food.
You've got Stanley Tucci going around
my
Italy.
My name's Matt Smith, and I'm passionate about reduced food. Join me on my journey.
Fuck off, old woman. They're my yogurts.
It gets feisty, when, especially in the bakery counter, when they can see them with the gun and they're putting the prices on.
Yeah.
And people are pushing. I've been there.
The worst fight I've seen at a supermarket is over reduced food.
Yeah.
I was at a Tesco, a big Tesco at 9 in the evening, and I put down the yellow stick of food, but they were like, it was like 5p for chicken wings. It was like, this was like end of the week, everything's got to go. And there were these two guys waiting, and the...
Them, didn't you?
Yeah, man. They're gone now.
You were there twiddling your 5p.
It's bad the way people like treated.
Can we hear the end of this story, Ryan?
Sorry.
I mean, it's probably funnier than what I would have said, but there was two guys waiting for it, and then the guy that was stickering them, whatever, I don't know what the word is, he said, now you can get it, and they started pushing each other, pushed one guy onto the floor, just so he can get these shit chicken wings.
I used to be the guy with the gun, reducing stuff.
Really?
You get regulars that come in and they some of them kind of like to, they play it like a bit of a game, like they just, discover them.
Yeah.
You can see them like doing a loop of one aisle, just like hiding and waiting.
Oh, no.
One you woman love in particular. The attention.
Yeah. I'm going to do it. And they bring stuff to you. No, they're looking at dates on all stuff.
Yeah.
Yes. Do you know what I'd do? I'd have a yellow sticker that just says, got you.
That'd be devastating.
Got you, bitch.
Yeah.
£100.
Direct.
Well, I'd do that.
Yeah.
Could be the villain in Max Smith's.
Oh, just yellow sticker items.
Max Smith, bargain hunter.
Bargain hunter.
There we go. Beautiful. Yeah. Bargain hunter.
Yeah.
Yellow sticker boy. Yeah.
Sorry, Ryan, you were going to chime in with something real smart, real quick.
Yeah. I was going to say how it's weird how the people treat food differently, don't they?
Yeah, man.
Like, you know, everything else is like stacked up properly, but the reduced section, it's like Primark on Boxing Day, you know?
It's
all messy stuff everywhere. Yeah.
I've never been.
I've got better things to do on Boxing Day.
I'm with my family, mate.
Yeah. And fucking Primark. With my comedy notepad.
There's a reference to everyone there. You know when you're in Primark on Boxing Day?
Christmas is done,
it's over. Forget Christmas.
Not until next March.
I don't always go. I
remember when I was getting to know you that you often spoke about Boxing Day and your family.
New Year's.
So me and my mates used to go Boxing Day sales, and my family would go.
Used to camp out, didn't you?
Really?
Did we never camped out?
You got there really early. Didn't you?
Like, and he was like, "Ooh, any break?"
I don't know what you just said.
Any cheek bag?
Camp out. And he was
when he got to a joke.
Really had to force that fucking Boxing Day bit in, Ryan.
It's got to go in now.
Yeah, man. I went to Athens. When was it? Thursday morning.
Nice.
Got to the airport real early because apparently Manchester Airport, which I'm nowhere near, has a lot of big queues. 3 hours to get through security. Got through everything in 20 minutes. So 4 hours early.
Yeah.
Nothing was open. Oh. We had to queue to get into like the bar bit. They opened half an hour late. just to have some porridge. Everyone else was having drinks. And it was like 4 a.m. and I hadn't slept. And I thought, I'm just going to have me porridge and snooze on the plane.
Porridge, then a Jaeger bomb.
Yes, please.
Porridge in a Jaeger bomb.
Just throw it in the face.
Porridge bomb. Oh, that was fun.
Yeah. I wouldn't shout that in the airport just before you get
porridge bomb.
Oats everywhere, devastation. But I went to Athens, and it was a strange place because it's a big capital city. You know, you think of the Olympics 2004. He doesn't, but us cool cats do. A lot of empty buildings right in the centre. So many things just closed down and empty. Went on a little tour of Athens, and they had these headphones where you could listen to it. It was like cheap headphones, so I just snapped Zoe's. Like, you got them for free, and then she was just sat there like this, thinking it had stopped.
Oh no!
I mean, it was the most interesting stuff. Because we went to the thing that we wanted to go to, which was the Acropolis, and that was like the first government or something. I should have paid attention. But I was like, oh, you can see it from here. And then you had to queue to get in. Like a big queue. We had to pay like the queue jump thing. I was thinking, oh, we have to pay £25 to climb up this when you can see it from the bottom.
Yeah.
I'm not really much of a culture vulture, to be honest. Second ever went to the beach. Very nice beach, clear water. Woman got fingered. not that I knew.
Yeah.
It wasn't me, but apparently it's a thing they do in Greece.
We were snorkeling.
Someone fingered my snorkel. It was an attempt at my life, to be honest. And lastly, in what has been a very long intro, I got an email this week to go to a school fashion show from a student. And it wasn't ironic, and I thought, that is possibly the worst place for me to go. Yeah. A school fashion show. Me just turning up.
Yeah.
It's not like a paid thing.
I'm here to see what they're wearing.
Yeah. I'm just going to be selling it. Yeah, nice. You look good in that. Yeah. Hey, boy. Jasper, looking hot. if you've got any more invitations that wouldn't incriminate me as soon as I step there, it just sounds like... Do you like a paedophile hunter?
It sounds like a sting.
It's the most.
Would you do it for £500?
No.
Would you get involved with a sting for £500?
No.
Have a seat. Where's my money?
Money first, then I'll talk.
How much for you to go, Ryan?
to judge kids in a fat art?
No one said about judging.
A grand.
£1,000.
Grand.
Yeah. Okay. £800.
To judge kids.
Yeah. It's in Manchester. It's not far.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's probably like a 3-hour job. Yeah.
500 quid.
500. I would probably do it for 500.
I know you would. I think you'd do it for 200 quid.
I reckon 250.
Mm. I think 200 quid you'd do it.
And they get your taxi there and back.
Yeah, 150 quid, expenses paid, lunch put on.
Yeah.
Nah.
3 hours long.
£180 and everything else. I just said.
I think minimum 250.
Nah, I think 200.
But you worked at TGI Fridays for a lot less for more time.
And this is just a couple of hours out of your day to go and judge some kids.
Basically a week's wages for
a nice cooked meal.
No, I'll stick to my guns at 250.
You
initially said 1,000. We're going out quite a lot, quite fast.
I think you need to know about me, Tom. I will not be moved.
I am a man of principle, sir.
250, expenses paid, a nice school dinner.
School dinner?
If anything, that's the paedophile bit.
Where's my turkey Twizzlers?
Chips and beans.
What's this shit?
Have a school dinner. They're good.
Back in the day,
depends
I don't
on the school, mate.
I wonder what they're like now. You know,
if you're in Nairobi, is a school dinner that good?
Could be. We don't know.
Yeah.
If right you're in Nairobi, listening, get in touch.
Got a fashion show there next week.
Imagine expenses paid.
Oh shit, man!
Look, just a fresh school dinner, which I've slagged off.
Just the porridge bum. Before I go. God.
It's time for complaints.
Yeah.
Don't have a jingle for that yet. Hi, guys. Hope you're all doing well. Thanks. Thanks, Callum.
Thank you.
Just got one complaint. I feel as if Tom knows more about current events than we think. Just one week where he has a fully prepared response to Kim Kardashian crying over Roblox is all I asked for. Been a listener since day one, and that is all I want. I want to hear what sort of loony stance he has on these topics. Cheers, Callum. P.S. I used to love IMAX, but now it's sadly dropped off. Letting the people of Pompey down. Yeah, also sent this to the wrong pissing email the first time.
Sounds really honest and genuine, that guy.
No, I don't think so.
I thought so.
No, not at all.
I do try and be detailed as possible.
Yeah. Good for you, mate. Good
thanks.
Should we promo IMAX now? Is it a good one this week, Max?
Could be.
Right.
Let me put that at the start, black and white on the screen, and coming up.
Yeah.
We'll just have that.
Yeah.
We've got him on strings now, Ryan.
Could be.
Yeah.
Hey, lads. Big fan of the pod. Just one complaint. That Ryan fella, the one that looks a bit like an anorexic lesbian, he's been rubbing me the wrong way, if you catch my drift. Ryan! In the last few episodes of the pod, with Ryan, he has blatantly been giving his little man a few too many special cuddles, you feel? Throughout the whole last episode, in brackets an idiot abroad, Ryan has obviously been rogering his little torture throughout the pod, really putting the IMAX in climax. I don't know what you're on about.
I've seen that. Ryan will be looks like he's masturbating under the table sometimes.
Do I?
Yeah.
Maybe it's because I sometimes
you're always playing with it, but it looks like you're wanking.
I'll try to stop.
I did think
Thank you.
Mad that you've not said anything.
I did. I said something during the.
Oh, really?
I tried to call out Milton Schmegg. I thought it was part of the character.
Milton Schmegg's a good man. Max has got me saying, that's so true, all the time now. Please remove IMAX from the podcast.
The fuck?
This one's from George Gunner. Take the woman hating Tom Looney off my airwaves.
You hate women.
I don't know how this is happening.
There's Looney and then there's misogyny. I just won't take it anymore. George Gunner is gunning for you, Tom.
God.
I mean misogynist.
I've just got a bad segment. You hate women.
But when's this?
That's insane.
It is insane.
God. Is no, no, mate. I believe that.
It's not time for the news.
Hey.
MP Neil Parish was caught watching porn. Says he was looking for tractors, not porn actors. I've just chimed in with porn by an harvester.
Nice.
Feel free to laugh, Ryan.
I did laugh.
Yeah. Microphone didn't pick it up.
Before he said it.
Ooh, no. Preempting my joke. Are you reading this?
No.
Ryan, what do you think of that?
Yeah, I didn't know about this. But
you shock me. You're not up to date with current affairs, including politics.
Yeah, pretty dodgy that, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
I think he went off it and went back on it.
Oh, really?
And I mean, you're shoulder to shoulder with colleagues.
Like, sort of, you know, turn it off and on, see if the tractors are appearing.
There was a minister that went on to defend it. I think he was an MP or he's from the House of Lords or whatever, older bloke. And he just gave the most shitty excuse. It was like, they asked, you know, did you believe his excuse? He says, well, I actually know the tractor he was trying to search. So, yes, I could see how that could happen. Doesn't divulge anymore. But, just kind of, okay, we've got to accept that then.
Where was he?
Apparently he was looking for a tractor and some big jugs. Some big oil jugs for his tractor so he could fill it up with fuel.
Yeah.
So he could double penetrate the tractor with his fuel.
Yeah.
Fuel rods.
Yeah.
Gay orgy. Ever had a gay orgy, Ryan? How much for that?
all expenses.
And a school.
An all-inclusive gay orgy.
And a school meal.
I'm standing my ground at £500.
Really?
No, I probably need a bit more of that.
Yeah.
Thousands?
Continental breakfast.
Pretty scared.
Scared? No. Everyone there is cool. Safe words.
Yeah.
Protection.
Yeah.
As in
lovely penises.
Yeah.
Oh, amazing penises. Yeah,
really good. Right, really good. Yeah.
To be part of a gang.
£5,000 for half an hour's
work.
There
has to be a price.
Yeah.
Fuck. £5,000 is so much. Yeah, I guess so.
A bit weird.
Yeah, man.
I wouldn't do £5,000. No, thank you.
I just said
pretty high.
Bangs £5,000.
That's a school meal.
Yeah. Start a Patreon, make that money.
We'll talk to that on a second channel.
Yeah, man. Or if we ever get to the 200k subscriber special, Ryan's getting fucked, man.
I feel really down that I've said that. I don't know. I don't think I can go through it.
Hand back under the table.
Right, we're not giving you £5,000 then. If you're not going to go through with it, forget it. Ex-footballer Jamie O'Hara said, I remember a teacher telling me once, you are never going to be a footballer. One thing that gave me great satisfaction was turning up in my white Bentley and parking outside her class. Why's he parking outside of school? In a Bentley, trying to show off. I like the idea of
great satisfaction, didn't
say. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Just showing off to the kids, beeping his horn. Just the headmaster comes out. Jamie, why aren't you at training? Do you believe that happens?
You always hear, like, people that do well say, my teacher once said I'd never do well, you know. So I feel
loads of teachers.
I feel bad in a way, because the teacher's like, you know, the amount of people that must say I'm going to be this and I'm going to be that. Most 99% of people aren't. So if you don't tell them to focus on the work, then and they leave with no grades, they'll be fucked. So you have to take that approach.
I remember, Ryan, you told me that your biology teacher said, you'll never make £5,000 chonging dick. You should send him a video, mate.
Yeah, he will.
You covered in cum with a load of money.
Then he's the real winner.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll be there.
Yeah, maybe.
You never know. Roll wearing balaclavas.
Sir?
Can you take a picture for my tick? Wait a minute.
Is that him, Dad? I don't remember you from Ben this evening. My boy's not thick as shit. Look at him now, shining. Quite literally.
My maths teacher said to me in school that I can't add up two numbers from parents' evening.
Okay, 91 plus 17.
91 plus.
Oh, repeating the question to buy time. You're pathetic. No,
I'd have to work it out. So.
Well, yeah, that's how it works.
Yeah.
Some time.
Hey.
108
minus 18.
Do you
work on the tills at TGI's?
I do, but they do all for
you. Clip that up and send it to your teacher.
Imagine you edit that right down there. It's now time for our first segment.
Ooh.
Oi, did you hear what that loony bloke just said?
Pete Davidson appears to have the initials of Kim and Kanye's kids tattooed on his neck.
It's a bold move.
Oi, did you hear what that loony bloke just said?
Well said, Tom. It's now time for an old segment, but we brought it back with good reason. It's Slag Off a Podcast.
Have we got rid of who's that quote?
No, 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 oh, sir.
Right. Hey! I didn't want to do it. No, you'll like this one.
I got one, didn't I?
Yeah.
I didn't think I celebrated enough
such a
in the moment.
In the dark, man.
Yeah, no stabbing.
This week we're slagging off a podcast called Sloppy Joe's. apparently this is Joe McGrath's new podcast.
How many has he got now?
I know. We nicknamed him Sloppy Joe for his work rate.
And his boxes after a night at the kennels.
What's the premise of it?
Don't ask, mate. Just two people called Joe. The other guy he's presenting with actually read out a comment that I aimed at Joe, which yeah. I paid to comment on a stream, and he read it out thinking it was about him and being banned from kennels or pets at home. Narcissist.
Yeah.
Sloppy and the Narcissist, that's what you should call it.
So Joe Stone. Sloppy.
It's now time for Tom's favourite segment. Yo, they want to know.
Quote from. Come on. What's this?
Come on, Ryan. But he's £5,000 up. He loved that one. You liked that, didn't you?
£5,250 up.
You've got to laugh. Imagine if they're like half an hour apart. You just turn up at the school covered in gum.
The guys I are am ravenous.
Oh, a lot of laughter in my segment. I love that.
And the mood takes you, and you give the £5,000 as a prize to the best dressed.
Turns out the 250 was in vouchers
for more scored meals.
back from Naomi.
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 Naomi. Shit.
Oh no! Now you look stupid, right? Don't worry. You've got that maths bit to fall back on.
Let's keep this good energy going with that.
Stop
great
laughing now, everyone.
Right. Thing. I hope you've been watching the news.
For
this great quote. This is for me.
Paul Chuckle.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
The Reverend Al Sharpton.
I think I've got this one. It's Keira Knightley.
Okay, it's sadly none of them. It was Olivia Wilde.
That's good.
Oh, when she gets the thing.
Yeah, have you heard about this? Mm. She was at CinemaCon. She was served custody papers while she was on stage.
By who?
Just bailiffs.
Custody of what, though?
Her and Jason Sudeikis broke up. And she's got the kids. And Jason Sudeikis wants custody. So she was served papers during a convention.
Prop ones?
So a bailiff has to give you the paper, but has to give them to you.
They knew she was going to be there.
They knew she was going to be there, so they went. And
why can't they share custody? Yeah.
Yeah, man.
That's what my parents did with me.
Great segment.
So look how I turned out.
I don't know. I didn't read the papers.
It's now time for You Laugh, You Lose. This week it is Max Smith. He laughed at my really good Osama Bin Laden landlord.
I love that. Yeah, it's good.
I was going to name the podcast Bin Laden's Landlord, and then I was told that was a stupid
idea. You text me saying how clever it was when I slapped.
I never text you, mate. Better things to do with my time. Just
going out.
Yeah, I just
start. Do you need a timer?
Yeah, just start the timer start when now. I come back in.
No, that's
start
not now. Fair. That's not fair. You're not going to laugh when I'm out of the room, are
you? You might. Is it the idea of what is he up to? How are you feeling, Ryan?
Yeah, good. Don't want to laugh.
Yeah, finger those cheeks. I'm thinking of the orgy. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're a flirt.
Shit.
3, 2, 1. Go, Max.
Hello, lads. It's me, Lou. I made our toilet roll holders, and I've got some shit jokes for you. Get it shit because of the toilet roll holders. Anyway, what do you get if you cross me with Ryan Locke? Shit jokes. Anyway, there was a guy who was sat on me the other day. He was my crack dealer. Hey, I tried to buy a house. They said, is it for rent? I said, no, it's two lets.
Fucking Yeezys.
I didn't get you laughing. I don't know what will.
Fucking Yeezys.
was there any panic when you come in like that and immediately you didn't get picked up?
No, I didn't. That was very good.
Yeah, that was very
thank
good.
Thank you.
That's way better than slapping your head. Yeah. I mean, afterwards, I just felt angry.
Yeah. Some people's humour's different, though, isn't it?
That's so true.
I don't lecture us on your humour. It's now time for the talking points.
Ooh.
I have one. Do you have one?
Yeah.
Do you have one?
Yeah.
Again, we've kept you in the dark, Tom. That's how we like to do this.
If you had to join the emergency services, which one would it be?
Nice, I like that.
Why have I got to do it?
Don't know. No choice. The only jobs left is police, firemen and ambulance.
Is this all in Britain, or could I choose what country?
No, Britain.
Just
not
in Britain.
Rescue.
No.
Have you had dealings with them recently in your tour group?
No.
What about the mounting rescue?
Oh,
you're mounting all those men. Oh. No, rescue you.
Nice.
Is that one of them?
No.
Oh.
Unfortunately not.
You know, obviously, I'm going to think the fire boys. What are they called?
Firefighters.
That's the one.
Yeah.
They look cool, sliding down that pole.
Yeah.
But then you're risking your life when you go into those flaming buildings. But you're also a hero. It's clear that you're a hero because you're saving people out of a burning building. Tricky.
Oh, God.
Most dangerous, I'd say.
You would see some anyone that you're in, you would see something like life-changing, I think.
Yeah. Well, funny the way you look at it, you know.
Yeah. <you're> Everyone's humour's different.
Quick, slap yourself in the face.
Oh, boy.
I think I'd want to be in the police.
Yeah.
I don't have the stomach for the ambulance. You know, it's not in my nature to be quick thinking when someone's dying.
Yeah.
I'd rather be an investigator. Is that an emergency?
Yeah,
we need to crack this case.
Do you want me to open this up so you can be mountain rescue and things like that?
I don't want to be mountain rescue.
Okay.
Yeah. Ryan, what would you be?
But I would have been mountain rescue, but
that wasn't even an option.
Yeah, no, it wasn't an option. A policeman was my original one.
No, policeman.
Just because.
Oh, what about the lifeguard people in the sea?
Coast Guard,
Coast Guard. Is that one?
Do you know, I would pick Coast Guard because they probably. You would see, obviously, dead people for drownings, but not.
Might not find them.
Huh?
No.
Don't see it. I'd say for stuff that you see, they'd probably be the best.
See? Coast Guard.
Guys, it's layered, this podcast.
Yeah. So I don't think I'd want to see a burning body.
No.
I couldn't be a paramedic.
If you want to see hot body, go to that fashion show, right?
Fashion show. And a policeman, you'd see all sorts, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
So Coast Guard, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to go police. Cruising around in whatever they drive, Vauxhall or something.
I am going to go police. I'm not interested in being a paramedic. Great job that they do. But
should we be good cop, bad cop?
That's what I was thinking. I'll be good cop.
I'll be shit cop. Oh, fuck. I've got my handcuffs. I've got a zip tie. Stop riddling.
Good Coast Guard, bad Coast Guard.
Just in a peddler and a pipe. I don't like the water.
I'm seasick. You need help. I need help.
Based miles inland.
I'd be like, Max, someone's drowning over there.
Go on.
Come running down.
Oh, a bit of improv.
Psych.
Oh, God, that's awful.
That's really awful.
Yeah, do you call 999 and go, psych, nothing's wrong?
Well, no.
It's the same thing.
Yeah, but when you and me are good cop, bad cop.
I'm not a cop, I'm a Coast Guard.
Coast Guard, sorry.
Good cop, bad Coast Guard. What the fuck is that?
I don't watch that.
There's only one man for the job. Sending the Coast Guard.
So you're going Coast Guard?
I'd go mountain rescue.
Sure.
Good cop, and bad Coast Guard. Living together in a flat.
I think I might go firefighter.
Yeah.
Do you reckon? Yeah.
I feel like it's more simple. You're there, you save bodies. You don't have to deal with, like, the police. Are they going to stab me or not?
Yes. Mm.
The people you're going to need help. I guess emergency services as well, but...
Yeah.
I guess as well, elephant in the room, the police are not seen in such a great light at the moment.
I think so.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah? Wow.
But you'll have to be both good and bad cop now.
I will.
Yeah. That's because I'm being good and bad firefighter.
Mm. Water pistol.
Right in the face. Fight fire with fire, man.
Flame bro.
Petrol bomb, Ryan.
God damn it.
You don't deserve to be in the Coast Guard.
That's, prank calling the Coast Guard.
Same as flame bomb.
Petrol bomb.
Same as a flame
What's
thrower?
Wrong with you?
Because you've had to make that. The flamethrower has just landed in Tom's lap.
Right, okay.
And you've made a petrol bomb. Right.
Yeah.
Oh, Ryan.
Also, with fuel.
Sorry.
Fuel prices going up.
Oh, you inconsiderate.
50 quid a bottle.
Think it through.
No, no. And that's why you're not going to be in the Coast Guard. You're now in a call centre. Playing good call centre, bad call centre. Just hanging up on people.
I'll phone you back.
Why say that?
Max, do you want to go for your...
Okay, you ready for this, guys? What is the worst thing you would do to your worst enemy? Because there's the phrase, I wouldn't do that to my worst enemy.
Ooh, nice.
I've flipped on its head.
Yeah,
I've flipped them on the head.
Yes. Oh, I'd there you go, them. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll do the same.
Yeah.
And then pull the pants up.
Oh, you would do that as well, would you, weirdo?
And then I karate chop the dick.
Oh.
Or vagina.
Yeah.
Worst thing I would do.
Yeah.
So, worst enemy... Let's say they've killed my wife.
Sure.
That's worst enemy to
me. Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not just, see, you know, they start looking at a charity football match. I'd better probably kill them.
Yeah, fair. Wow. Murder.
Worst enemy.
Oh, shit, so it's... Murder over there. I wouldn't kill them. I'd just have a good stand talking to. Yeah. I'd lecture them for hours.
I always think that if I was to retaliate...
Mm.
All I'd do is kind of, you know, I'd cheapen myself. I'd, you know, I'd damage my own soul. And it doesn't bring the person back.
Ryan, what if you cheapened yourself and you were going to the orgy for a grand?
How might you cheapen yourself?
Cheapen myself.
Oh, sorry, at the orgy. Sorry. Yeah, yeah. I thought you meant he got to the orgy and cheapened himself further.
You're at the orgy and your worst enemy is there.
Yeah.
Right. What
filming
do you do?
Filming
you.
Shit, knowing that...
But they've got a gorgeous cock.
Right. Yeah. Oh, pristine.
Proper 10 out of 10.
The best one of the lot.
Oh.
He's just drizzled some honey on it. Love honeycock. Yeah.
I'll probably grab his
Alpen.
Dick.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I love that. I love that.
Get your money's worth. I mean...
I kind of want to be your worst enemy now.
I'm squeezing or you killed my wife. You little bitch. And then I'd grab his balls. Like, what are you going to say to this? Slowly toss it.
Slowly, yeah? Real slow. Real sensual.
I'm so angry.
I love... Remember my dead wife?
Because I don't anymore.
I love the thought of like a really serious thriller about a man trying to get revenge. And it ends with a gay orgy.
We've found where the organised crime group are lurking. Leave my Glock, I'm taking the strap on. You don't need a strap on.
Ah, fair, Ryan, fair play.
Yeah. That's bold of you, mate. You're a better man than me.
I don't think I could physically kill him, though. I mean, you know.
I wouldn't kill them just in shooting them or anything. I'd probably capture them and try and take them somewhere where I'd get away with it.
Yeah.
Mm. Formby Beach.
I would do a Miss Doubtfire and marry them.
Yeah.
And then I'd reveal myself and say, "Oh, I've not killed your wife, but I've got rid of her."
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's very good.
When would you reveal it after a long night of love?
It was our 50th anniversary.
On our deathbed, as we're cuddled up together.
Remember me? No, he had dementia, unfortunately.
It's just as you go to do it, you have a heart attack.
Is that how I'm going to go?
Could do.
Yeah,
could do.
My one is, if you had to be in fancy dress for the rest of your life, what would you wear? Peter Pan or Captain Hook?
I think maybe something that's a onesie, because then...
the Tinky Winky one, that's sort of
Can
one.
You take it off to shower?
It's
your only outfit.
Your clothes are now just fancy dress. Yeah. One fancy dress outfit.
Mm.
Danny Zuko, maybe.
That was mine, Danny Zuko. Great for a funeral, because it's black, apart from the white T-shirt.
Yeah. Yep.
Cool on a night out in certain venues.
Yeah.
Day to day.
Yeah. James Bond.
Wow. Are we talking tuxedo or just trunks coming out of the sea?
Yeah.
Either.
Hawaiian shirt on the beach.
Why are you wearing just trunks at a funeral, mate? Your wife's funeral. You're eyeing up a bloke. I'm going to wank you off so slowly.
I think something with a onesie.
You're obsessed with this onesie.
I just think it's an all-rounder.
Can you name a fancy dress outfit that it applies to?
Just a monkey.
Could say
an animal.
A monkey.
An animal.
Yeah, whatever onesies.
That's so impractical.
So you're dressed as a sloth. So your dad, so this is, your kids go, oh, where's daddy at the school playground? Oh, there he is, dressed as a fucking, you know, goat or back end of a horse.
Yeah. Sure, yeah. I think it would spice up my life.
Back end of a horse.
It's spicing up and then there's the next 70 years dressed as a fucking animal.
We're wearing jeans, white t-shirt and a jacket and you're dressed as a fucking animal.
You said James Bond, you should have just gone with a suit.
Well, yeah, but that's just not
James Bond wore an animal.
It's either James Bond or a monkey.
The master of disguise.
James Bond's cool.
I don't know. In my head, when we said about fancy dress, I was just thinking of my options like.
Yeah, but you went for James Bond first, and then went for the monkey.
No, I said the onesie first, actually.
What about Woody from Toy Story?
Yeah,
jeans,
a good one.
Shirt,
yeah,
but, waistcoat,
but
hat.
Yeah, no, yeah,
Spider Man.
What about a James Bond onesie?
No, they don't exist.
They could do.
It's got to be one that you could just go to the shops and be like, oh, Jimmy Savile.
Yeah.
Ali G.
Okay.
Ali G.
Marilyn Monroe. Yeah.
Marilyn Monroe, yeah. You said she was a bitch, didn't you? You keep thinking in silence, Ryan.
Tina Turner.
This is good content, this.
Max, who are you going for?
Waluigi.
Who's what? That? Oh, the
from Mario. Yeah, I like the colour purple.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Like hats.
What about the Joker? That could work at a funeral.
There you go, I'll be the Joker. Point. There you go.
I think people would probably be scared of you as well. Though,
that wouldn't be the Joker then.
Mm-hmm. Back to Waluigi.
Jedi.
Yeah, Jedi. Jedi. Palpatine. It'd be Palpatine.
It's now time for this hot segment.
Stephen lies. Stephen, sweet little lies. Oh yeah, he's proper fit and gives me a wide on.
Prefect badge.
I can see clearly now.
Oh, stop with your distraction tactics, Ryan.
It's bigger than normal. Look at them.
No, what's them?
Very numbskulls.
That's worse.
Prefect badge.
Yep.
So I'm assuming one of you was a prefect or maybe you stole it off someone.
Yeah, man.
Let's get into it. Hey, Tom, what is this to you?
So I have a shoebox at home inside a larger box, both boxes full of keepsakes and sentimental things.
Like a storage unit thing.
Yeah, kind of don't want to throw away. I was doing a purge of that last week to make some space, and I found this. I've never seen it before in my life.
Oh, really? Mm. Interesting. Thank you. Ryan, what is this to you?
This is my prefect badge from when I was in year 10, but I had to stop wearing it.
And Stephen, what's this to you?
This is my prefect badge. I got it in year 11, when you would be a prefect.
Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Tom, what else was in this big box of tat?
I've got some old mobile phones from school, cards, little, like my student card from Zavarian and stuff, just loads of little things that kind of from milestones in my life.
Not Valentine's cards. Virgin.
There was a Valentine's card in there.
Virgin.
Any cards that Devin gets from the show, it's quite a nice message, so I don't want to throw them away.
So you chuck them in this. What's the most recent thing you have in there?
There will be some stuff from my 30th. Devin did loads of stuff from my 30th.
Okay,
some
cool.
Pictures and did an album and stuff.
Right.
But we're
so it is a box that you frequently use.
What songs are on it?
Frequently enough, but
album.
So I've got a shoebox,
yeah,
which started out as the keepsake box,
yeah,
and I've acquired more stuff. So that box now sits in a larger box.
Okay,
but I've been trying to like put some stuff away and just minimise what I've got out, ready to move out.
Were you ever a prefect?
I wasn't a prefect, no. But this is a St. James prefect badge. I think Andrew was a prefect. David was head boy. I don't know where I could have acquired it from, but it was in there with. I've got a Man United badge, and I've got a badge from
Virgin
Explorers.
Yeah,
Virgins.
A lot of laughter during my segment.
I was busy exploring the vulva. Yeah. Is that a bit?
Right.
I'm not too sure.
I'll take your word for it. Yeah. Thanks, Tom. Ryan, why did you get kicked off being a prefect?
You know, isn't it?
So I didn't.
It's Ryan's. You were a pedo.
As if they wouldn't kick you out of the school. Just take this off you.
I got it in year 10. We do have prefects in year 10.
We do have pedos.
And I had to stop wearing it because I was just getting
even
bullied.
In year 10, he was a pedo.
I've actually, people have been calling me a pedo like since school, though. Like since.
That's not good. That's 10. Not something you want to brag about. Yeah. Well, stop it.
You have one mic in the change of rooms.
Making $5,000 for this.
Yeah. First year I got.
Why didn't they take it off you? Why did they let you keep it?
I didn't want to be a prefect anymore.
Oh, so you just.
Because I was getting bullied so bad.
Right. Things haven't changed much.
It was awful, to be honest.
Right.
The first day I became a prefect, I was wearing the badge, and this guy, his name's Brian.
Strange name for a kid.
Fucking Brian.
Yeah, it just ripped my English book in half.
Fuck, how strong is Brian?
This is what I mean. It was quite surprising.
Right.
He did. He ripped it in half. And I was very emotional about it. And
why would you be emotional? Is a book
kind of emotions English.
Were going through your mind?
I was top set English.
What?
I was top set English.
Fuck
off. I got 2 B's. It's everything else I was bad at.
You're not getting into top set in my school with 2 B's, mate.
Yeah, man.
Sting all the kids.
Stephen.
Yeah, man.
You were a prefect?
Yeah, you know I was.
Interesting. Why? What was the process to becoming one?
Well, in year 11, you would be a prefect. Not year 10, they're just dicking around. Year 11's are the highest and they have the authority.
Mm.
The process was, basically, I think your form tutor had put you forward.
Yeah.
There's a group of us in our form that could be a prefect, and then it was up to us whether we wanted to be.
Right.
The main attraction for me was, of course, the green went great with my maroon blazer. And also...
And you were a fashionista back then?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Man, that might be a lie.
Okay.
But you could get on the bus early. The bus is home.
Nice.
So it's just me sitting there with the driver.
Yeah.
2 boys not talking. You there as well, Raj.
Were you friends with any of the prefects?
Yes, one of my best friends in school.
What? Were you friends with any of the prefects?
Yeah. We did it with 2 of my mates.
You did it with 2 of your mates? Weird. Yeah?
One of my good mates was head boy.
Oh, nice. Nice.
It was Gary and Keith.
One was bus driver.
Brian, Gary, Keith.
Right, I am going to say, I can't believe it's you, Ryan, because of your... anecdote about a kid ripping your book in half. That's impossible.
No.
How the fuck
did the yellow pages?
Yeah.
Honestly, this
have
guy,
you tried ripping?
He's
I've
huge.
Tried.
He's
it
huge.
Doesn't matter how big he is. You could be King Kong size. And he can't rip a book open.
Pull the door off.
Fucking going to school with Eddie Hearn.
The famous strong man.
Yeah.
Eddie Hall?
That's the one. Yeah. Eddie H.
Goes to the school with 40-year-old businessmen. Monetize that written school.
I think it's Tom's.
Incorrect.
Cool. So you're Stephen?
Tis I.
Well, there
I
you go.
The prefect.
Well done.
Can I just say...
No, you can't, Ryan.
It's now time for the viewers' most embarrassing moments. About 4 years ago, me and my family were driving across France. I was a bit of a porky lad, so for most of the drive I was sat in the back, stuffing my face with sweets and fast food from the side of the motorway. On that particular day, we got to our hotel and decided to walk around the town to find a restaurant. It was a town called Brest, and it was clearly very posh. During the walk, I felt my stomach start to play up. I didn't think much of it, so we continued to eat and walked back to the hotel, past what looked like an outdoor wedding. We got back to the hotel, and only then did I realise there was a huge shit stain down the back of my white shorts, which I had been walking around in all evening. Oh,
that's grim.
All evening?
Really is poor.
Yeah. And no one else has said anything?
No.
Oh.
Yeah. And me on holiday, chalky pudding on my shirt. It's now time for IMAX.
Fucking hell, I hate this segment.
Hello, everyone. It's me. It's me, the great reviewer of movies in the world.
Good afternoon.
The great, not the greatest.
If you like movies, then this is the place to be, because you'll hear some great opinions about movies that you've never heard before. This is the great movie Annie. So do you want to hear my review, Ryan?
Sure.
Thank you.
He already knows our answer.
Most enthusiasm you've ever got.
A lot of laughter in my segment. Love that. When I sat down to watch this movie about a small ginger kid whose life had been irrevocably changed by their parents' relationship, something tugged at me. This seems all too familiar.
Brilliant.
What did you fart?
You narcissist.
What
mate.
Did you do?
You said tug at me.
Oh, come on. This is about kids.
You know what? You are actually fuck off now.
Yeah,
yeah?
You don't get to hear my off,
Ryan. Get out.
You don't get to hear this review.
He has worked hard on his review and you're making it all about
you.
Say
another word.
Get out, Ryan.
Come on, let me listen to IMAX.
No, honestly, you're not missing anything. It's fine. Go on, go.
Get out, Ryan. You've ruined his segment.
This is a mercy.
That's like a really interesting bit of the review as well.
Fucking mercy.
Yours wasn't a joke, though.
Can I stand?
Yeah, outside on the other side of the door. Sorry about that, Max.
That's all right.
No.
It's disgusting cool. behaviour. Where was I?
Near the end.
6 out of 10, good movie. It's a bit of my dad doing donuts in an Asda car park, but we're not going to hear that now, are we? Because Ryan fucked it for everyone. Yeah? All you IMAX heads out there, really excited for this review. I'm not going to hear anything about me and my dad cruising down the freeway listening to Jay-Z. No! No, instead you're going to hear Ryan talk about me tugging him off or something like that. I don't fucking know.
I'm going to have a word with Ryan.
Yeah, please do.
Ruin this day. Right.
Furious, mate.
Yeah. Hello?
Razzle-tat. Hello there. Oh, it's toasty warm in here.
You caught me, shoe. Cheeky boy.
Sorry, who are you guys?
I'm DJ Mike.
I'm DJ Steve.
Welcome.
Do you know of us?
I've heard of you.
I actually have your option for my wedding.
Wow.
Fantastic news. Oh, yeah. You're booked in next year, aren't you?
It's just a pencil at this stage.
He's our booking. That explains a lot. We are North Cheshire. Michael! We're trying to broadcast.
Oh, sorry, DJ Steve. Do carry on.
Thank you. We are North Cheshire Radio.
Yes, we are.
We are two of the hot shots over there. You may have tuned into us a few times.
I have done in the past.
Yeah.
For some time though, you guys have been off the radar a bit.
No. We're
traveling.
Check your radio because we are there. Have you unplugged us again?
Hopefully not.
We had this. Little boy that worked for us, Sloppy Joe, we named him, just rolled around going, chicken wing. He moaned a lot.
Is this Joe McGrath?
We didn't get his surname. Didn't bother to learn.
Don't need to respect him that much.
He was there about a day.
Yeah. He was showing us loads of pictures of dogs on his phone, wasn't he?
Were they dogs?
Oh, I think
so. Oh, God, the stuff he did to them.
What's in North Cheshire?
Hopefully you, sir.
Oh, loads of houses.
I'm sort of going for this angle. Right. You're going on about the fucking
you
house.
Go,
I mean,
go,
oh, God.
I'm interested in what DJ Mike's saying.
On the radio.
DJ Mike, some houses, did you say?
Well, there's loads of houses in the North Cheshire area.
Right.
So, you see, we would often play... We love this.
What's the real estate market like there? Don't even worry about it.
Mike, don't get flustered. You're doing great. You're a pro at this.
I'm just
mate.
Not used to the cameras. Voice for radio.
Don't take any notice of the complaints we get. All right?
Yeah.
Especially from the authorities.
Yes.
You do you.
Yes.
And it wasn't racist.
Exactly.
It was clever.
There was an incident.
If you can do Irish, why can't you do Chinese? That's what I always say.
It was annoying because I was practicing that Chinese accent for hours as well before.
And it was good. It was good.
Very good. Very convincing.
Can we hear it?
I don't think we should.
I think we need to.
It's one thing. It's one thing.
No,
to
I think we need to hear
to,
this.
It's one thing to corrupt our own station, which we
haven't. No, don't worry about this.
To risk this gem of a podcast.
Don't worry about that.
We've all sorts has been done on here.
If you backtrack on our shows on the website, then you'll find it.
Could you give us like a taster of what your show's like? Like, if imagine we're like, ooh, you know, we've just tuned in.
Yeah.
What time is it if the show's just starting?
Well, we have the 10 a.m. slot. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Real juicy slice.
Just past, you know, driven to work. We're at work now.
I've got a coffee.
Yeah, yeah.
And I've put my
little earbuds in to treat myself. And I've pressed play on the whatever.
Okay,
I'm working from home in a house in North Cheshire.
I'm just going to play a jingle here to try and help me.
Cammy Whammy G tells you how it's going to be.
The show would be over by the end of this one.
Hello, welcome to We Are North Cheshire Radio.
I'm DJ Mike.
I'm DJ Steve, and you're my co-host, DJ Mike, so you really don't come in there, you know.
Yes, every time I do that.
Yeah, and it feels like a power move.
Yeah.
It feels like a power move. First of all, I said, don't touch the Bombay mix. You've gone after that. Yes,
yes, it's my favourite herb, form of mix. Continue, DJ Steve.
Well, you'll enjoy my mix today. My mix of tunes that I've selected from my case to the side. A few good records will be played.
Cheesy, cheesy, cheesy.
No, they'll be good tune. They're not cheesy. Mike, why'd you come for my music taste?
Oh,
you like my taste of Bombay mix. You like my music taste. But when we get on air, you show off.
I just like you a lot, DJ Steve.
Michael, don't worm your way out of this. I've thrown you a bone here. What happens after this show goes off the air? You go round Cheshire doing Uber Eats.
Yes, I do. That is exactly what I do.
And I go home and plan the next show. You know, we have different priorities, Michael.
Yes, yes. But I'm thinking about the show whilst driving.
Sure.
I'm getting so much work done at the moment.
Can you read out one of the questions from the listeners, please?
Absolutely. It says, the other day, I was walking in my local cave and a bat hit me on the face.
Right.
What can I do to prevent it?
Don't walk in caves. That's the instant thing that comes to mind.
Yes. There are a few.
There are. Yeah. Yeah. You dwell in one, don't you,
yeah,
Mike?
I do.
Oh,
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, don't point your cigarette at people.
Sorry,
that's aggressive. That's aggressive. Yeah. Not on the carpet. We'd burn us out of another studio.
Oh.
No. Not. Don't make that noise. It's not. It's not exciting, is it? Okay, why are you intrigued by that, Michael? You're a pyromaniac.
Sorry, everyone. I just got too
along
excited.
With a sex addict and a racist.
Right, well, I'm not a sex addict.
Anyway, there's a little taste of what we get up to at 10 a.m. to 10:03 a.m. We are here because we've tuned into your podcast.
Mm.
Get a load of this, Mike. They do podcast these young boys. In my day, we...
so modern.
We just worked as an apprentice at the radio station.
That's true.
Or at your father's butchers.
Yeah.
Not yours. He was dealing with different meats down at the old prison cell.
Yes.
But we're here because we've listened, we've tuned in, and we've enjoyed it.
Oh, wow. Incredible.
You had me chuckling.
Oh, yeah.
A good few times.
Yeah?
Mike, speak when spoken. We're here to see if you, sir, would want to join Wank Radio.
Wank Radio?
We are North Cheshire Radio. We believe you have a North Cheshire sort of heritage
accent
within you.
Yeah.
We think the people on our show would love you.
Yeah.
It's about time. Show.
See, I'm a little concerned.
Steve.
So obviously this podcast is all right at the moment. It's going okay, and you sound like that. You often get in trouble.
No, he does.
Right.
Please see me as a completely different entity.
Yeah.
Mm. See me as more of a co-worker.
Okay.
Again, please see me as different. Yeah. Well, Mike, you've been on a downward spiral, haven't you?
A little bit of a downward spiral. Yes.
Yeah. He's cut out the alcohol, but it's just all about porn with you.
Yeah. Sure. I am pretty obsessed with. Asian men and white women.
Asian men and white women.
Are you seeking a replacement?
Possibly.
What?
You know. Michael, you threw up on the dashboard the other day.
I don't believe it. It was a pure accident.
No, it wasn't.
It bloody was.
No, you.
I was drinking your beers.
You're a menace. You're a havoc and you're a menace. Oh,
this is Do you want to join this?
Why are you smoking indoors?
You made this situation very awkward.
I took you into wank radio when you were nothing but an 18-year-old boy. Oh. Look at you now, 48, stinking of piss and dressed like you're on Top Gun.
I'm dressed for the job you want. That's what they say.
Uber Eats! Uber Eats, Michael!
Yes, well, I want to work at Uber Eats so I can maintain this job.
Yes.
This radio job.
If you didn't get fined every bloody week, you wouldn't have to work at Uber Eats.
Well, sometimes it's good to do crazy things.
Constantly going on about Asian men and white women.
Well, it's bloody good porn.
I'm sick of you, Michael. Absolutely sick.
This is sad, isn't it?
Yeah,
absolutely.
You guys have been working together for some time.
Maybe too long. Maybe it's time.
All he goes on about these days is going to a hen do in Bangkok. What's that for?
Oh, bloody great times, and I just want to relive it.
Michael, so, I cannot carry on with you.
I just can't believe this is happening.
Really? The writing's been on the wall, quite literally. Our boss put Mike, you're fired.
I just chose to ignore it. Just assumed it was talking about someone else.
What a scoop for the podcast, are you?
Yeah. I mean, I assume so. I assume these guys are, you know.
Yeah.
No. So you're going to take my place then?
Would you take his place? Because we will need a replacement on this podcast.
Oh, that's a very interesting thought.
Well, I'm sure he can.
All
do
in
you
favour,
do.
Say aye,
I guess.
Oh no. You see, Wank Radio is a bit of a sinking ship. Maybe I could join your podcast, boys, alone.
Maybe we could have
45 years radio experience.
Give them an old segment to do right now.
An old segment.
A reliable source. Yeah. They can work with that.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
An old segment. Our friend Stephen does it. Basically, he says a great source and we'll give an answer.
Yeah.
So do you want to give a source
give
and we'll...
Answer.
Yeah, I'll go for the source. Are we ready? Tartar sauce.
Oh. Oh. Plate.
Porn.
Oh, Michael! Michael!
I think we've got everything we need, boy. Yeah. Yeah. Is down.
I'm sick of you, sex pest. I'm leaving.
Don't follow me, Michael.
Well.
And if I
order from Uber Eats, make sure Gregory delivers it.
Well,
who's Gregory?
I had no idea who was wearing shorts.
I really don't know if I should.
If you could leave as well, that would be
cool. You may as well stay. You don't want Ryan back, do you?
Oh, that's a good point. Yeah, do you want to join the podcast?
Yeah.
Oh, 100%.
I'm glad you're on board. Okay.
We'll see how this goes.
I think now we'll just wait for Stephen to...
Yeah, I don't know what he's up to.
Quite sad now.
Can't find Ryan.
Hello there.
It's all right, we've got this bloke on the podcast.
This is
DJ Mike, is that right?
That is right, that is correct. Yep. I'm going to be your new co-host. You, me, against the world.
That's not what we agreed.
You and me
Mr.
against
DJ
the
Mike.
World, taking on... Oh, I can't believe you ripped my moustache off. I'm so pissed off. Oh, spots. DJ Steve, where are you?
Well, that's beautiful.
Oh, that was it was all a bit of a blur. Sorry, guys.
It's all right, mate. Where have you been?
I was just looking for Ryan.
Oh, it's a small apartment.
I know, kicked him out.
Barn conversion.
This is Mags's shed.
Bigger than I thought.
Yeah, in a way. It's a bit like the TARDIS.
Yeah.
It's now time for our next segment, which is... Oh, Ryan rates. Oh.
Well,
shit.
Sure rate, Ryan.
Yeah, oh God, yeah.
10.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to be mean.
No, don't have to be mean then.
Well, like on the podcast or just in general?
In general. I'd give him a...
In general, a 7. On the podcast, about a 4.
I'd give him an 8.5 in general. As a bartender, about 2.
Yeah.
2's very generous.
Hello there. My name is Ryan Locke.
Send him off! Send the dirty guys off! Get him off the field! That was diabolical! Get him off the field! That's just typical what it is! Get him walking!
Welcome to Ryan's Crying. As you know, last time I was on, I famously did things that were overrated. So this week, I'm going to do things that are underrated. Kicking us off. Cats. cats are hugely underrated, in my opinion. Because like, dogs get all the limelight.
They're like one of the biggest pets.
And dogs.
Yeah, but there's still
dogs and cats. I mean, it's cats and dogs.
Yeah. Yeah.
I just don't like cats, mate. Yeah. I'm allergic.
For the ones that do like cats, they'll get a cat, won't they? And they don't they don't like cats, they won't get a cat.
Yeah. Remember, this is just going to be my opinion.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
You know, there will always be a counter argument.
Are dogs liked?
Yeah.
I think dogs are way more liked.
But then people ask the question, are you a cat or a dog person? So obviously they're held in sort of a similar esteem.
Do they? Yeah.
I've only met like few people.
I know lots of people that like cats.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. More than.
It's different kind of demographics, isn't it? Like, you know.
Look at ancient Egypt, they fucking love. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, yeah.
They loved cats.
Yeah, man.
Big
have
cats.
You got a cat or a dog?
We always used to have cats, yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you seem like a cat person.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. But
the family liked them?
I think seven times out of ten, you say to someone, are you a dog or a cat person? And they say, a dog person.
Is this. Have you got evidence of this?
Just ask 10 people. Go out and ask 10 people.
That's not a big enough sample size for the world.
No, not at all.
10 people, whatever. Well, that's one family that love dogs.
Yeah. Yeah, family barbecue.
Apart from a couple of black sheep in the family.
Barbecue and a cat. Hey, Ryan.
Yeah.
This is all just stemming from the fact that your pet cat was mowed down.
Was murdered.
Well, murdered, really. If anything, you were an accomplice. Maybe once you get over that, you realise cats are shit.
Maybe. They're not shit.
I love my cat.
I think cats are
wonderful.
I think they can be just as funny as dogs. I think their
funny.
Attitude. Yeah.
They are different. I like them both.
But number two on the list, hiccups. The feeling of a hiccup. Right? It's not talked about enough.
I hate that.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't enjoy it.
You like having hiccups?
A hiccup is a 10% of an orgasm.
No, it's a sneeze.
You need to get back out there, man.
A sneeze is an eighth of an orgasm.
A sneeze.
Yeah, hiccups are awful.
Oh, God.
You've just been eating a load of dry bread.
You're certainly not underrated.
Yeah. I was going to say an itch as well. That's the same thing, pretty much. That feeling of...
like an itch.
Yeah.
No one have got eczema, though.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Have a wash.
But that feeling, it's amazing.
It's ingrained, no? It's ingrained in your mind.
Talking about sex, yeah?
Yeah.
What are you on about?
I just don't really know. And the last one is buses. I think they're underrated.
You think buses are...
I fucking love a bus.
Yeah.
If you've got a good seat.
What's a bad seat? What's a good seat?
Good seat. Good seat is a window seat.
Yeah.
Bad seat is not a window seat.
Yeah, because you can't see out the window if you're on the inside.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't mind being in the middle at the back. I might just...
But what about when the bus driver hits the brakes and you just go flying down?
Yeah.
It's bad.
Straight through the windscreen.
Yeah.
God, think of the damage you do to that windscreen.
Yeah. Yeah, I know, but he was going fast, man.
Ooh. Yeah, can a woman not drive, Tom?
Ooh.
In this scenario.
Oh.
They're mainly men, aren't they?
Virgin.
Yeah, I love that.
I've seen a few female bus drivers, but, you know, one of my mates is a bus driver.
You got them sacked, didn't you?
I just think they get a lot of hate, buses. Without them,
I think it's the people that are on the bus.
What kind of hate do they get? Can we have some examples?
If you were to walk past a bus and shout out hatred at it, like what would you say?
Just bus wankers.
That's the people on the bus, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's been done before.
What about
as well?
The bus itself?
People don't like how it hisses when it stops.
Yeah,
nice.
You can't have one that one. Stephen said that one.
It's also not a hate comment.
I don't know. People hate bus drivers sometimes.
Again, it's
sometimes.
It's like, you would shout, people hate bus drivers sometimes as a hate comment.
People hate bus drivers?
I've got mixed feelings about your colleagues.
I think you're underrated.
Maybe like, don't stop here or I'll get you.
Yeah.
What are bus are you on?
Are you at a bus stop?
Are you on the comfy bus? You're licking those windows too hard, man. Well, Ryan, you've completely changed my way of thinking. What a great segment.
Hey!
Join me next week when I'll be doing Overrated again.
Oh, really? It's going to be like a loop.
Are you starting your own podcast?
Yeah.
I look forward to seeing that next week.
Sloppy Ryan.
Sloppy Ryan. Spilling water on the microphone.
ASMR. I've broken my equipment. No.
It's now time for Tom Looney.
Hey. Looney. 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 Looney.
climax. Ow!
You ruined it.
I was like, did you not do it?
He did do it. 6 out of 10.
Yeah, yeah.
Him and his dad's cruising around listening to JC.
Yeah. Yeah.
Jealous.
Got a quiz this week, boys.
Oh!
That's what you hear it for Looney. That's a Tom, is this a Looney hairstyle?
That's good.
Does that get a point?
So today, the theme of the quiz is nature.
It's just nature. Yeah. You know, it frustrates you.
And we're playing for some beautiful nature-themed prizes.
Sorry, mate, I just stood on your foot.
This gorgeous rainbow canvas.
Oh, I want that.
I know.
No, is that the top prize, or did you get to pick if you win?
No, there's two prizes. This beautiful rainbow cactus. And I know Ryan famously has an intense sexual bond with cactuses.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
That'd be a lovely new housewarming gift for you.
That's good stuff.
And nature's greatest treat, a giant Toblerone.
Wow, I want both.
Yeah.
Do you ever stick a condom on it and shove it up your ass?
Yeah.
Which one?
You ready?
Yeah.
10 questions, really straightforward.
Oh, wait.
Doesn't matter where you
are. It's a wipeout quiz.
We have like an obstacle course.
No wrong answers. A wrong answer nils it all. Yeah? So if you don't know the answer, leave a gap. A wrong answer will nil everything that you've got. Okay?
Oh, yeah. This is going to be blank, isn't it?
You might win it with one. Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
We all understand the format.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I guess so.
You ready? Quick fire. 10 questions.
Ryan.
Number one. What type of creature is a barracuda? Number two, which planet in our solar system is thought to weigh 2.5 times that of all the other planets combined? Play along at home. Three, which gender of mosquitoes bite people?
Oh, no, misogynist Tom. It's got to be the women.
Number four, which gas makes up over 90% of natural gas?
Oh, fucking Nora.
Number five, which wood is used for piano keys? God, this is intense. So wacky. In which ocean would you find the Bermuda Triangle? That's question six.
Oh, I'll go for that.
Question seven. What is the only living organism that can be viewed from space?
No, fuck off. Fuck off.
Well, Jesus, you know something
Christ.
I don't. Number eight, what type of leaves does a koala feed on? Number nine is, which are the only mammals to have wings? That was number nine, yeah.
Only mammals to have wings.
Only mammals to have wings. And question 10, humans and chimpanzees share roughly how much DNA?
Barracuda. Barricade.
It's because it's the wipeout thing is making it difficult.
I've got one answer.
Really?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
A living organism.
Yeah, I just can't.
Just listen, this is great content.
I think I know what it is, but I don't want to put it in because that's the last answer.
Because it's a wipeout quiz, man. Look at their faces.
Oh, it's so annoying. Cause
are we ready?
Pretty sure I know, but.
You ready to go for it? Okay. Do you want to mark each other as I go through, or shall I just? It's probably quicker if you mark each other.
I think I'm getting zero here. Yeah.
First max.
There we go.
You ready?
Can we get people done for spelling?
Within reason. No, not really.
Spell right.
Not really.
Eel.
Oh, fucking hell. Question one. The answer is fish.
But an eel is a fish.
It's a shark, isn't it? It's a barracuda shark.
No, barracuda's a fish.
Is it?
Yeah, it's just.
It looks like an eel.
No, it's just. Well, it's just kind of longish,
but it's an eel.
Just...
It's a fucking eel.
Fucking hell.
No, it's not. You spell it wrong anyway. You put E-E-E-L.
So you two are done after one.
Yeah. Oh, is that it?
Yeah, it's
wiped out. It wiped out the answers.
It wiped out the answers,
Yeah, all but you can still keep going, can't you?
No, that's it.
I thought it was wiped out the...
No, it wipes it out.
Get one wrong, they're all wrong.
So, right, fair.
If I've got one of these wrong, I've lost.
Oh, for fuck's sake, right, okay.
Shall I mark the others to see who got the most out of them?
Question two, answer is Jupiter.
Oh, I'm out.
Fucking hell.
I thought Mercury's heavy.
Mercury's quite small. That's for fucking hell, yeah. Three was female.
Yeah, we got that.
Four was methane.
Oh, no.
Five, ebony.
Yep.
6, Atlantic Ocean.
Fuck off.
7, the Great Barrier Reef.
Nah.
8, eucalyptus.
Nice.
9, bats. And number 10, I would have accepted 98 or 99%. The answer is 98.8%.
You see bats.
Max, you got 3 out of 10.
Thank you. Ryan, you got none.
Yeah, well, I thought it was Caribbean.
I got one right.
Okay, I'm going to dish out these prizes just because that was my intent. I don't want to take them home.
Sure.
This is not going to plan. But you did get 3 right, Max, so you get first dibs on the prizes.
I'm fine with either, so it's up to Stephen.
I'd rather have the cactus, please.
I'll have the Toblerone, please. Yeah, thanks.
Hey. Thank you very much, Tom.
Thanks, beautiful. Tom.
Well done, Max. Very good knowledge.
You wanted that cactus, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, it looks so pretty.
You buy your own.
It. Absolutely gorgeous.
Don't mind. Don't mind.
Gorgeous cactus.
Buy your own.
Just have to win the next one.
It's the last quiz ever going to do.
Nice one, Ryan. 0 out of 10.
Not fucking doing that again.
Numpty dumpty over here.
I just can't believe that fish question.
Yeah.
It's an eel.
Sorry.
Because it's long. Whoa. It's a fish.
Oh, yeah.
Absolute fish out of his head.
All right.
There we go.
I was wrong. I was wrong. I don't deserve a prize.
No.
Didn't get one.
We weren't arguing that.
Calm down.
Hit film Barracuda.
Fair.
Maybe you could review that for us.
Yeah, I might do. Oh, yeah. we didn't do the
random movie generator.
Yeah. I will just give him that then, yeah.
Well, I might not find that.
I think the listeners want you in the movie or involved in some way.
Yeah.
So, audio.
Yeah.
How many options do you want?
Just whatever.
9.
You've got War Games from 1983, The Breakfast Club.
Yeah.
1985.
That's good.
No Way Out. 1987.
I'll do Breakfast Club.
Nice.
You know me, love my breakfast.
Cult classic,
good film.
What's your favourite breakfast?
Fry up.
A fry up.
Lovely fry up.
Cheerios fried up. Crisp as can be.
Don't care what it is, just fry it.
Yeah.
Doesn't your dad do a good sausage?
Your mum does a chipolata, doesn't she?
Are these like sex jokes?
No.
Oh, of course, what the hell?
Tell me about your mum's beans. Really right. Tasty. Yeah. Didn't you say you just sat there and licked it for ages once and then ate it?
Any cold beans, though?
Like it cold.
That's how I feel. Put it to the max.
Oh.
Put it to the max, to the max, put it to the max.
Help! I'm losing my mind.
Oh, no.
And I need some advice. Over lockdown, I've used me mate Jack's gym to get proper fit. Pecs as big as Jordan's. No, not the boob lady. I'm talking about Jason Jordan, the WWE wrestler. Started watching his stuff last week. Anyway, Jack, me mate, has seen how good I am at this stuff, and he started using me name and hotbot to promote his business. I'm fuming. I don't want to be associated with his crap gym. He's got shit on walls. And last week, some bellender spray painted Jason Jordan's got a fat cock on the toilet walls. Anyway, help me put an end to Jack, please, lads.
So, this guy's best mate Jack owns a gym.
Yeah. But he sort of views, like, is using his, like, sort of image and name to promote it.
Yeah.
Which, you know.
But yeah. Does his mate let him use it for free?
I didn't say.
You still need to have that conversation, don't you?
Sure.
Yeah.
On some ways, take it as a compliment. Like, it's, I guess, I don't know. I'd take it as a compliment.
I know, but would you want your body out there and associated with...
The gym that's going on about Jason Jordan and his fat cock. That's not a gym I want to be a part of.
Yeah. And obviously the poo on the walls wasn't...
I can take or leave that.
It's a tough one. It just needs to...
Crass graffiti isn't cool, is it, Ryan?
No.
If you had to graffiti a gym, though, what would you say?
Pump more iron.
Where do you draw the line with gym graffiti? What's too far?
Things like this man, you know, calling people out saying they've got a small knob. Like,
why does that affect you?
This Jack has crossed the line.
Yeah, Jack. Yeah.
Said he's got fat cock, didn't he?
Yeah.
Fat cock.
That's different, though, isn't it?
Think about a man's cock.
Why? Yeah.
Anything.
Well, yeah. Like.
What about a woman's vagina?
Yeah, even that.
You wouldn't want that on the wall,
though, isn't it? You wouldn't want to walk in and see old Max Smith's got a massive penis.
Love that.
Yeah.
They're good press.
Yeah.
Do you want to write this out?
get to the bottom of it.
Of course. Yeah.
Who do we need? Jack, the guy who wrote in. I don't know his name.
Brian,
yeah.
Yeah, Brian.
Strange name for a young boy. Yeah. So we've got Jack, Brian, maybe a gym worker or a gym goer.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe the janitor cleaning up everything.
Yeah.
Just be working out.
Yeah, because my job's to clean up the shit and the graffiti.
So are you Jack?
Yeah, you be Jack.
And you're the person with the issue.
Yep.
The gym goer and janitor.
Mm. Yeah.
Do your job!
Sorry, Jack, mate, I've got so much scrubbing to do!
You're fucking useless.
No, please. Oh, I'm so sweaty.
All you do is talk about meal deals.
It's good banter in the gym, innit? Don't take me fucking Toblerone, you twat.
Sorry, is this yours?
Yes! It's my lunch.
Hey, no. You've been smearing that all over the walls.
It's not jockey, it's poo-poo.
It's shit on the walls.
It's poo-poo.
What's going on, Jack?
Sorry to...
What's going on, janitor?
What is it my fault?
Well, you're scuffing a yard of Toblerone when you should be cleaning the shit off the walls.
That's no yard. Use a ruler.
I am the ruler of this gym, sir.
No, not to me, you're not.
Now clean the shit off the walls.
Fine.
Sorry to interrupt.
Hey, shush.
Hey, it's fat cop Brian.
This is what I wanted to talk about.
Shit on the walls. Is it your shit?
Jack. It's not my shit. Look, on the
you
walls.
Come here, you steal my protein bars and then they go through you. Shit all over the wall.
You've been giving them out.
I've not been giving them out. They are locked behind the cabinet.
I thought they were free.
Unless the janitor's been dishing them out.
No, I don't do nothing here.
Jack, I wanted to talk to you.
You've been grooming muscly boys. We do. Excuse Now's me. Not the time. Janitor handles everything, unfortunately.
Yeah, I am. Come in.
There's a protein bar.
No, don't take this, you cunt. Sorry, I meant you slut.
That's much better.
That's more ad-friendly.
I want to ask who's been putting writing up on walls of my...
James Jordan.
Where are you from?
My cock.
No one's... You're not James Jordan. You're Brian. You're small cock Brian.
That writing's there under shit.
Oh, yeah.
Clearly, keep going.
Stop. I want to stop using me to advertise in your gym.
What?
You've been using me to advertise for your gin.
Gin? Do you do gin now?
Gin.
Protein gin.
For your gym.
We can make it protein. Yeah. Put a pack of mint in the bottom.
It's just starting to piss me off, Jack.
Why are you pissed off? It's all those roids you've been having.
I'm very grateful that you gave me the place for free.
Free gin? Free protein bar?
Fucking hell, Brian. Keep free it gym. Down. You puny cocked idiot.
Pay £100 a month.
That's what I want to be associated with.
Shit on the walls.
Yeah. That's protein stool.
Pays my wages, that.
This man gets £100 a month and he's not earning it. Shit on the walls. All you've done is play around with your Toblerone.
It's tasty, man.
Back to the issue at hand.
Yeah.
You want gin.
Well, I'll take some gin.
I've got a bowl, a beautiful bowl. It's got a hot man on it. We call him Brian. Don't tell this boy.
Yeah, well, got a stop great body for gin. For the advertisement purposes.
Why?
Because it's embarrassing.
It's not. You should be confident about your body.
You should have at least spoke to me. Fuck you in your gym.
Don't you sweat at me in the gym. Look at all these buff boys around you. They'll pound your fucking head in.
I'm cancelling. Well, I'm going to not join up.
They'll take
now.
A few of them, lag.
Cancel what?
Cancel your £0 membership. I'll miss that.
I'm not coming anymore.
I've already got the pictures of your body. See the webcam in the changing room? Yeah.
Webcam in changing room?
The only thing not covered in shit. Oh, I shine in that one.
I've got everything I need to launch my lucrative gin business alongside the gym. Wait till I start my jam. Oh, then I'll be raking in the pounds.
I don't care what you do, just delete the pictures of me.
Well, no, I've just said I've got everything I need.
I'm finally ready, but I'm going to delete it.
By you, Brian.
I'm crossing the finish line of business success. You want me to take 26.2 miles backwards? Fuck off.
Fuck you, Jack.
Oh, God, piss off. Piss off.
But there you go.
Yeah.
That's, yeah.
Jack needs to stand his ground.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's business.
It's the final
question. This one is a Max Smith special.
Oh.
If you were a serial killer, what would your M.O.B.
Ooh.
That's number the Queen gives you, Ryan.
I'd probably leave a word search behind, but one that I've made myself.
Oh, the words are wrong.
Fucking hell.
It's like the words.
Are we just going to gloss over who you've killed and why?
I've killed my old maths teacher. Said I couldn't.
There you go, mate.
Numbers. No, I'm killing her.
Right.
I'm killing her.
So you're killing a maths teacher and leaving an English
word
style.
Search.
Yeah, clues.
Going after all the teachers that doubted you.
Yeah, just her.
A lot of deaths.
Just her.
Even teachers from other schools, they just saw you walking by. Yeah.
She's not really a serial killer then.
Just one teacher.
Once.
Oh, yes. Yeah, no, I'll kill them all. No, I'll kill all the maths teachers.
Ooh, yeah.
In the world.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
God. It's going to be my... That's extreme, Ryan. Yeah.
Leave word
and you'll
searches.
Leave word searches at all.
Yeah, yeah.
what are we to make of that?
What's going
to
be in the word
the
search?
The words are going to be like...
Like Ryan.
Yeah.
Whoops.
That's my address.
He always spelt wrong.
Now, a few weeks before the first death, this boy came in to use our printer. 4,000 word searches.
And then he came back for our dictionary, and then he came back for more word searches.
He came to use the printer.
He bought Tippex. Buckets of the stuff. I turn up at the scene of the crime the next day when the tape's all around the body, and I just walk along and go, "Ooh, what's happened here?" Every time.
I never see you coming.
Oh, no.
Every time. Okay. How many are you going to kill?
As many as I can.
Right.
And then I'll be, "Oh, God, again?"
You never catch me doing that.
Bloody hell. Yeah.
My glove.
I had ones just like that. That's sort of the angle I'd go for.
That's good.
Just teasing them.
Yeah. Well, I'd like to think there was something just about what I was doing. Maybe I could have a YouTube channel where I killed paedophiles.
Yeah.
You probably, do you know, you get a lot of, you got a lot of likes for that one.
Leave a like and subscribe, guys.
I'd have to be anonymous.
Yeah.
But there'd be so many clues. Maybe I won't put it online.
You'd have a YouTube channel that's just private.
Yeah, different. Yeah, forget the YouTube channel. Don't worry about it.
You could see
a podcast, then you can't see it. Just an audio only podcast.
Yeah. I would sit on the top of Everest and just kill all the mountaineers that come up.
Yeah.
Right.
What are you going to do? Like, obviously, they don't
just chill out.
Yeah.
What about if there's like a group of them?
I'd just kill them all.
Right.
Okay. Are you going to be all right getting up?
Oh, yeah, you've got to get these.
Are you kidding?
No.
I'd fly there, helicopter.
Right.
Easy.
You just step down on top of Everest and slip. No! Wipe out everyone and kill the bags.
Just a big snowball just rolling down.
But your Toblerones fell out halfway down.
You can see them from space! I'd kill mountaineers.
Anyway, I've been joined by...
Sorry. Oh, sorry. I'm still going.
Tom Looney.
Looney.
Thank you very much.
He called you Virgin Looney, mate.
No, I didn't.
Oh, Ryan.
Max Smith.
Sorry.
Not a virgin.
Smithy.
James
Corden. Ooh, that's worse, isn't it?
Sorry. It's out of order, mate.
What's going on?
And Ryan, the look-a-lock.
Ryan. Come on, guys. Ryan.
That's what you'd be saying at that orgy.
Ryan.
Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Bye.